friends, welcome to the Smart Exceler. Now we have moved on from Excel, normal Excel, to Power Query and Power Query to Power Pivots, and now we have come to VBA macros. So I know there is a question in many of the users that when you go to developer tab, when you get the developer tab, if you don't have, just Google it and find how you get the developer tab. There are in insert, you can see form controls and ActiveX controls. So it was quite difficult to us because you have many more controls over here and you have a limitation of form controls. So what are actually the form controls and what are ActiveX controls? So I'm going to just give a nutshell, a bit of information in what actually these things are. So let's open the form control button with a command button and let's add it over here. So its name is button 3. So we can say okay, no worries, it's a button 3, and then we can open a active same button over here. So when I open this and when I draw this one, so you can see the buttons are quite similar. It's very difficult to make out which is the active control and which is the, so now if you click and if you get this type of error message, then this is a form button. And if you click here and when you get this, it is a ActiveX control button. So apart from features, you can see I can directly right click this from here and I can get edit text and I can edit the text, a grouping order. This is assigning macros that will be showing you. Format controls are there. I can make it bold and I can add some colors. And I can do a lot of things in alignments, protections, so margins, and I can write some alternative text also. And if you, let's get this into black and I can just maximize it. And I can even edit the text. So edit the text, I can write whatever I require. So I can write controls. So you can make the control. And here you can see it's totally different. So you can see design mode, and you can see a formula, and the properties are over here. You can have a color. So if you go to palette color, you can have a different color. You can have a transparent feature. So it will be a transparent button. You can see it's a transparent. You can see this is the transparent feature, and many other features. You know, you can just see in groupings and orders and format controls. So it's the same like that. You can write your text over, you can make the alignments. So I don't want to go more on that. You can just practice this. So what actually is the use of these buttons and how we can use it? So to be starting in the nutshell, I'll be starting from this one. So if you want to use this button, either you can write codes in modules or worksheets. So if I double click this, you can see it's going like this, and if I double click, you can see automatically it's generating these things. So now I can go to view codes and I'll be writing a code. So I don't want to have this one, so I'll be inserting a module. So if you insert a module, you can use the code in any area. But if you are opening here and if you're writing the code, it will be for the particular sheet, and in the workbook will be also for these things. So if you write in the module, it's, you can use in any area. So this is my first module and I'm going to write a code. So for code, I'll be writing a form. I'm writing as a form. Automatically it will do this. And I'm going to use this area. So I want to use this area, A2 and A2. So for A2, in the form of a range, I can write this range. I'll be opening the parentheses, double quotes. A2, I'm going to close the double quotes, close the parentheses, dot value equals to, so I'll be copying this same, control C, and I'm going to paste this, and I'm going to make this as plus 15,000. It's a simple code. So you can see this is A2. So if I have a ring range, I can easily mention A and 2. Now if I want to make to A3 through cells, I can range, I can write A3. But if I'm using cells, I can write this as cells, open the parentheses, And here I am going to refer this as a row index. So the row is 1, 1, 2, 3. So 3 is my row. So I'm writing this 3, comma, and my column index is 1. So A is equal to 1. So I'll be making it as 1. Please refer to my video on column versus columns and row versus rows, so we can understand this. So here also I'll be writing this value equals to, I'm going to copy this again. Control C, I'm going to copy this space, and I'm going to increment by 30,000. So I have written two codes for this now. So we don't need to say automatically, it gets saved. And so now this one, when I click, I have not assigned a macro. So when I click, right click and assign a macro, so it gives me sheet1.form. So I will do OK. So this code is written behind that. So when I click this, it gives adjustment. So let me just check this again. View code. Okay, so it was not written in the macro. I'm just sorry for that. Control X. I'm going to copy and Control V over here. So it's a form. So now it's written inside a module. So now if I want to assign a macro, you can see form, and I can say OK. So we have written code here 10,000 and 15,000 and 30,000. So when I click this, you can see the value is getting incremented. When I keep on clicking this, the value gets incremented. So it's a code. You're giving commands to the system. You don't want to manually do this add and manually add, keep on adding. So it's a code. So this is the use of this button. You go and assign a module and you write a code and you assign a macro. It will write a code for you. But what about this? What is the use of this? Now I will go to the same module. And as I told you, if I write the codes here, it will be limited to this sheet. Now module is for the whole workbook, and extra other workbooks also you can use this. So I'm going to copy this. So I'm going to copy this. I'm going to close this. So now you have seen how to assign a code for this form button. You have to open the button, or you have to write the code in the beginning, then assign it. Then you have to assign macro. But here it's a Dactive X control. So you are having a superpower. You have, if you're very good in codings, directly go there and double click this. But if you double click, it's not going to open. You know why? You should go to design mode. Now when you double click, it gets open. And already there is a sub command button click. So now if I control V and I paste this, I have to remove this because already there is a subject over here. So it's written as private sub. So sub is for the module and private sub is with the command button, and I have to remove the end sub. Now we already have incremented of 15,000. So what I will be doing this is I'm going to minus this. So whatever is plus over there, I'm going to minus this. And I'm going to close this now. Now will this work? If I click, will this work and will this decrement the values? It's not going there. We know why. Because we have to, the design mode should be in off button now. You can see now it's switched on. Now if it is, it's a switched on. When you switch on, you can select this. But when you switch on, you can't select this. So you can see now when I click this, automatically the values are getting decremented. So it is going to negative now. And when I click this, the values are getting incremented. So this is the difference between form controls versus active controls. And I'll be showing you many more ideas. And please refer and please follow this section where the codes are written, how to write code in range, this workbook sheets menu. So this is the basic things you have to understand, how to write for a range and how to write for a cell. The same code, you can see the differences. So I hope you understand this. And it makes your life, it's very good. And you can keep on incrementing if you don't have work. If you want to just have time pass, you also you can keep on checking what are the values. If you want to change also, you can go to this code and you can add your own value. You can multiply, you can divide, We can do a lot of stuff. So it's just a form of play button. In the future videos, I'm going to show you how to make calculators, percentage calculators, VATs or GST calculations, and all sort of forms. So until then, please try to understand this. And I hope you like this video. It's a very, very important video, because there are no much videos on form controls and ActiveX controls, and the videos which you are very, very difficult to understand. So just in simple terms, I just wait on you to understand how to work with cells and ranges to get on some platform. And I wish you like this video. So please keep on doing the practice. And you can, if you want, you can increase this for the other cell areas also. So see you in the next video, and happy learning. Thank you very much.